As King Midas walked into his royal rose garden, he stumbled over a strange creature sleeping in a flower bed. The top half of the odd-looking visitor was human, but his bottom half was covered with gray hair, had a tail and hooves, and looked very much like a goat. "Who are you?" Midas asked. But the creature did not stir. Concerned, Midas carried him to the court physician, saying, "This stranger seems ill. See to it that he is cared for kindly until he is well again." Thinking no more about the unusual guest, Midas retired to his throne room. Suddenly, before him appeared a great cloud, and out of the billowing mist stepped a tall, beautiful man. Around his head, he wore a wreath of grapes, and in his hand he held a bunch of grapes. The man bowed and said, "I am Dionysus, god of wine. I have come down from cloud-shrouded Mount Olympus, where I live with many powerful gods and goddesses, to thank you. The strange creature you helped today was a friend of mine, a satyr named Silenus. In return for your kind deed, I will grant you one wish." "A wish!" exclaimed Midas in amazement. "Oh, I must consider this deeply." His eyes brightened, and he said, "My two greatest loves are my young daughter and the glistening color of pure gold. The more gold I have, the more I want. I can never have enough. I wish that anything I touch will turn to gold." "Are you certain?" Dionysus asked in disbelief. "Why wish a curse upon yourself? How could the touch of gold be anything but a blessing? Gold is as dear to me as life itself. Just think of all I could buy for my beloved little daughter." "I've made my wish," said Midas. "So be it," said Dionysus, and vanished. Midas felt an odd shudder come over him and wondered if his wish had been granted. He rushed out into his garden and went to a fig tree that was ripe with fruit. He touched a fig, and it began to gleam and glow. He touched another, and another, and another. Soon the tree hung heavy with golden orbs. "The richest king in the world should have a golden throne," shouted Midas, celebrating himself. He walked proudly into his throne room and went to his regal chair, one finger outstretched. He reached out and touched his throne. It turned to gold, and the room grew bright with its glow. "I am the richest king on earth. I should have a feast to celebrate endless wealth." "Servants," Midas commanded, "I am very hungry. Bring me the finest meal." Servants hurried toward him with great trays of sumptuous food. Midas's mouth watered as he selected a tasty morsel, but when he picked it up with his fingers, it turned to gold before reaching his lips. His stomach growled as he impatiently touched another delectable treat. He reached again and again and again, but each bite of food he touched turned to gold. "I can't eat to ease my hunger. Then I shall drink to quench my thirst," he said. "Bring me a goblet of wine." Servants brought him a goblet filled with wine, but when Midas brought the goblet to his lips, he saw that the wine, too, had turned to gold. Horrified, Midas wailed, "Is this why Dionysus called the touch of gold a curse? I am hungry, and I cannot eat. I'll be the richest man in all the world to die of hunger and thirst." At that moment, into the throne room came King Midas's young daughter, whom he loved dearly. When she saw her father so upset, she ran to him with her arms outstretched to hug and comfort him. He saw her running towards him and stretched out his hands to stop her from touching him, shouting, "Stay back! Don't!" But alas, his fingers brushed against her, and there before him stood his beloved daughter, with her small arms outstretched, and she was solid gold. Midas clutched his hands and wept. "What have I done? All the gold in the world cannot replace my daughter." As he wiped the tears from his eyes, his tears too turned to gold. "Oh, I was a fool to value gold over life itself," he wailed. "Gold cannot feed the belly or the heart. I wish this wretched curse could be washed away." Once again, the cloud appeared in the throne room, and Dionysus stood before King Midas. "Since you now regret your first foolish wish," said Dionysus, "I will grant your second. Go quickly to the river Pactolus at the edge of your kingdom and wash yourself in its waters." Like a madman, wild with grief, Midas ran from the palace to the river. He plunged into the water and washed and wept. As his tears flowed, they mingled with the river, and the sand on the river bottom began to gleam. His daughter's golden form returned to human flesh as the sand on the river banks began to glow. Some people who walk along certain river banks today point to glittering sand and say, "The shiny sand on the bottom of this river is just fool's gold or pyrite." "No," say others, "it might be real. Remember the old tale? This could be the very place where King Midas, so long ago, washed away the curse of the golden touch with his own tears."